It is time for another theme park coasting top 10 video, where we count down the top 10 rides and attractions at theme parks all around the world. So join me today as we count down the top 10 rides at Legoland Japan. Starting off at number 10, we're going to head into a fire truck and save LEGO City with Rescue Academy. Once the bell rings, you and your group will need to rush into the fire truck and pull the lever up and down to bring the truck towards the burning buildings. Your journey is nowhere near finished yet though, as once you make it there, spray the water and save the city. This is a great ride for any family or someone who is competitive just like myself, as once you win the race, everyone will go, "That person's on fire." From a fire truck to a boat, our number 9 spot is going to Coast Guard HQ, where you can drive your very own powered boat around many scenes and not crash, hopefully, wink wink. On a genuine note, this ride is very relaxing, and with the interactive element involved, from when I was younger to now at the age of 16, I have always loved riding it. A quick tip from us though is that if you are going in an odd group, each boat can fit 3 people, but with there only being one wheel and it being very cramped, it is probably best to have an even number per boat for the ultimate experience. At number 8, Splash Battle is perfect for those hot days in Japan with you getting just a little bit soaked. The best way to describe this ride is that you are sat on an open boat with water spraying at you left, right and centre for a 5-minute duration of the ride, with absolutely no spots to hide, so think carefully before boarding. This battle is not one-sided though, as you are also equipped with a water cannon, so you can get drenched all of those scallywags on the shore, however, unlike you, they can run away from the water. It is time for our first roller coaster on the list, as for our number 7 spot, we have the Dragon Apprentice. Now, before we even talk about the ride experience itself, I love the ride vehicle, as unlike all the other Legoland's Dragon Apprentice, this one really looks like it was made from Lego. The ride experience definitely does not disappoint either, with a 2-lap special consisting of a lift hill, followed by a helix and a bank turn, making it perfect for all those young thrill seekers wanting to build up to the bigger coasters at the park. For our number 6 spot on our top 10 rides at Legoland Japan list, the Observation Tower is a fantastic way to see the park and the surrounding area from 60 meters high. This attraction can be ridden by anyone, with it being indoors, however, with its bright color scheme as well as staggering heights, it is normally the first thing that people notice when they enter the park, and therefore can cause quite long queues at the start of the day. In our opinion then, we would leave it till later on, as not only will it be quieter, but nothing beats spinning 360 degrees at a night. Top 5, and for this spot you can head underwater in your very own submarine with Submarine Adventure. Since its debut back in 2017, this has always been a fan favourite, with all of the LEGO models and sea life immersing you in an underwater world like no other. If you want to have an even better experience, we highly recommend sitting at the front of the sub, as if you stick your head through those 2 portholes, you can get a 360 degree view and get some pretty awesome photos. No matter where you sit on the ride though, Submarine Adventure is definitely a must do at the park. Grab your laser gun and get ready, as for our number 4 spot, Lost Kingdom Adventure is the park shooting game. Located at every, and I mean every, Legoland park around the world, if you are planning to head on to another Legoland park in the near future, we would recommend trying the more unique rides at the park before this one. However, if you choose to ride, you will jump aboard a desert off-road vehicle and explore ancient ruins while shooting the coloured dots to build up your points. Be careful though, as along your way you may come across a few surprises. Like once, I played this game and someone in my group beat me, That sure was a shock. Talking about the more unique rides at the parks, Lloyd's Spinjutsu Spinner is a perfect example of an attraction where you cannot ride it anywhere else. Themed towards the famous TV series Lego Ninjago, you will learn the spinning techniques of Lloyd and customize your own experience. Let me explain. Each pod is equipped with two seats and a button. By pushing this button, you can choose whether you are going to have a nice leisurely ride or spin upside down, upside down, upside down. Comment down below what you would do. Here we enter the top two positions, and between number two and number one, it was very tough. However, we are choosing Flying Ninjago for the number two spot. Located in the same lands as Lloyd's Spinjutsu, this is always one of the great rides to do straight after to make the most out of your bricktastic day. Also, like Lloyd's Spinjutsu, you can control your own experience. As you fly through the skies like a ninja, for those who are brave enough can use the handles on the wing to spin themselves upside down while heading through the air at 50 kilometers an hour. This is definitely the most intense ride at the park, and for us, a trip to Legoland Japan is not completed without a ride on Flying Ninjago. Coming in at number one and the best ride at Legoland Japan, the Dragon. This attraction definitely has the overall package, as from the moment you enter into the Knight's Kingdom, you are absorbed in the medieval world throughout the land and the queue line. Once boarded, one thing that I love about the Dragon and what I have not seen on any other type of coaster that I have been on is instead of heading straight into the helixes, bank turns and airtime hills that this ride offers, the first minute of the ride you head around life in the castle, seeing all the different scenes as well as possibly even coming across the Dragon itself. I love the Dragon at all Legoland parks, but I really find this one so special, and for that reason our number one spot at Legoland Japan is going to the Dragon. That is it from our top 10 video today. Obviously you all have your own opinions and we would love to see them in the comment section below. Also, if you enjoyed the video, at the top we have got two videos that we know you will love, and at the bottom there is our Patreon page as well as subscribe button. But with all that said, there is only one thing left to say. My name is Tom Derrick from Theme Park Coasting, and I will see you for the next video. Goodbye.